In this Industrial Academy tutorial, I will guide you how can we calculate pressure drop in helical coil using various correlations developed by the various scientists and engineers. The question is, why we need to determine the pressure drop in the helical coil? The answer is very specific because we have to size pump for circulation of fluid in helical coil, and we have also have to determine the pressure drop at the end or the outlet of the helical coil for various application in different types of industries, for various applications such as heating, cooling. Let we proceed for the determination of the pressure drop in the helical coil. The necessary factor which affect the pressure drop in the helical coil are main diameter of the coil, pitch of the coil, number of turns of the coil, and material construction. By changing all these, the pressure drop in the helical coil will change. Now we proceed for the steps. Steps to determine the pressure drop in the helical coil. I will briefly discuss these steps. Most of the students of engineering students knows the how can we determine the pressure drop in the straight pipe. First of all, in first step we have determined the exact length of the helical coil, exact length of the pipe used in the construction of the helical coil, and related dimension inside outside diameter, and mean diameter of the coil, and material of construction. In second step we will find friction factor for the straight pipe. I will not discuss the determination of the friction factor here, and it is assumed that people know how to determine the friction factor for the straight pipe. Then using various correlations given below, we will find the pressure drop in the coil, helical coil, friction factor for the helical coil, and at the end this friction factor will be inserted in the equation used for the straight pipe pressure drop calculation. Then this equation will give the pressure drop in the helical coil because we are using friction factor for the coil, not for straight pipe. Let we discuss various correlation used for the pressure drop calculation used to determine the friction factor in the helical coil. First one is Planck's correlation for turbulent flow. One thing, important thing here, I am only discussing turbulent flow because the relation for the laminar and transition flow are discussed in the further lectures. The first one, the Planck's correlation for turbulent flow. Here we can see that Fc is the friction factor for the coil, and Fs the friction factor for the straight pipe, and D is the mean diameter and inner diameter of the coil. This equation is only applied in the turbulent flow regime. We cannot apply it in laminar or transition flow. The second equation is Wetton drop relation with velocity distribution. This equation uses velocity distribution and low number and other factors. Here we can see that in the various conditions and application range for the Wetton drop relation. The next correlation is the dust correlation. used for the coil. It can apply only in turbulent region. Here epsilon is the relative roughness and dt is the diameter of tube or pipe and dc is the diameter of coil, mean diameter of coil, and dt is the inner diameter of the coil and r is the round number. The next is auto relation for turbulent flow. This relation is mostly used, most of the authors follow this relationship to determine the pressure drop in the helical coil. Some books misprinted or misleading this exponent. They have used 0.5, but it is not 0.05 as a pressure drop calculations used in the Dennis-Moss pressure vessel design by Dennis-Moss is using 0.5, but is not 0.2 to 0.05. It is Dennis-Moss using that it is misprinted. It is 0.005. The next lesson is CM white correlation for turbulent flow in helix. Here will lambda naught is the friction factor for the straight pipe and lambda is the friction factor for the coil and R over R, R is related to the helical coil. It is R over R raised to power 1 over 2, although it is not, seems to be R over R, but it is R over R. Its application range is R. The best method to determine the pressure drop in the helical coil is to develop an Excel spreadsheet. You should put all the correlation here and helical coil related dimensions and put the formulas according to the correlation and find out FC for the helical coil and then pressure drop using pressure drop equation. In this way we can easily find out and analyze pressure drop in helical coil and effect of various correlation in proper and handy way. Thank you for watching. So please subscribe, share, like, Chemical Engineering Industry Academy.